Let's see what we can do with this. Probably then. First of all, let's see if this gate... We can go through this gate. Oh! Super Mario Sunshine? What? I didn't expect to be transported to a whole new world. Created by a single man. Sign, help me out here. Welcome to this small secret level. Oh, it's just a secret level. This here is a level inspired by the first level I ever made for Super Mario 64. You can find here one star. The name of the level is actually Peaceful Plains, but this here is on a level that normally doesn't have a name. So it will say Secret Stars as the name of it. Oh, that's nice. Okay, I thought I was transported to another hub world. But no, this is just based off of a first, first ever Mario 64 level he made. That's cool. That's nice that he put that in here. I didn't expect to get here through like a grate in the river, but hey, you know what? That's cool. Unfortunately, it's kind of big, so. I'm wondering where this star could be. You said there's only one, and I wonder if I have to find secrets. If I have to find multiple secrets in order to get something. And that star would appear at the top of that hill over there. It's a very nice place, I will say that. Hey, he was already making like complex. He was already making kind of large, complex level designs for a sorcerer. Oh yeah. We had to find secrets. I guess that makes sense. It's a good way to kind of like force you to look around his level that he created. This is their first one. That's pretty impressive, man. I mean, obviously, I'm pretty sure it didn't look like this. But if this is the basic design of it, I mean, that's pretty cool too. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah. I was saying how one of the strengths of this microphone is how the microphone is that close to your... Where am I going? How this microphone is like close to your mouth without actually being in front of your mouth. And it's bendable, so you can kind of change and move it however you want. Okay, it looks like that's how you get up here. What's down here? Another grate. Great. Another thing about I like about this headphone is actually the fact that it's not big and bulky. Because one of the problems I kind of saw when I was recording with my new microphone, like the big bulky one, was that because of its feature, I guess, of completely surrounding your ear, it kind of canceled out the noise, you know. It canceled out the noise, and you couldn't really hear much else when you had them on. As in, like, even playing a DS in front of you would be, like, really muffled if you had those headphones on. So whenever I tried to speak into them, it was just, like... I couldn't hear myself talk. I just could not hear myself talk. Which is kind of a problem when you're recording, because you want to hear yourself talking. At least I do. At least I like to hear myself talking, so I know when I'm being too loud or if I'm sounding like weird or there's something wrong with my voice or something. So I like that these old headphones aren't as... don't clamp on me as hard. Oh my god. Powerful Goomba right there. So I like that they don't... they're kind of loose on my head. I mean, not loose enough so that... I like those things just right over here. They're loose enough that they won't... that I can hear myself, but they're still firm that they obviously won't be falling off anytime soon. For the sake of my head, they won't move like that. Oh boy, where would the last one be? I didn't check the water, did I? Because over here is... the top of this hill is where the star will spawn at, right? Yeah, that's where the star will be. I like how that bomb just did not care about me at all. Ow. Oh, yep, there it is. It's under the bridge, obviously. He likes to put stuff under the bridge. Yeah, it is just... it's just a good headset. It's just a good headset with a good mic. Oh, and I should also mention that this headphone, my old one, has never lost connection while it's been turned on. It's never done that before, ever. I've only experienced that with my new headset, with the new gaming headset. I mean, sir, I've had problems with this, trying to get it to connect initially, like after I restart the computer or something. Like, I would sometimes have problems with it actually trying to, I would have problems with this thing trying to actually... the heck? Oh, that's an amp, okay. I have problems with it trying to connect it, like initially when I try to like restart my computer, it's not charging. It has trouble like actually connecting to the wireless receiver a little bit, you know, obviously, because it's not perfect. I'm not saying this thing is perfect. It's obviously had problems with that. There's nothing over here if I remember right. Yeah, there. I've tried looking behind that waterfall, there's nothing there. So our next stop is to try that gate at the very end of this path. Alright. Yeah. So this has never had problems with losing connection while it's on. Once it's connected, it stayed connected. Which got me really pissed off with my new headsets. Which is something that I just don't understand how that would happen. Oh, wrong way. Oh, that's way too high up.
Oh no, it's not there! Oh, I'm talking to the wall, and there's gonna be a ladder. You want to run it.
Okay, this is a good run. Oh, got it. Alright. What could be so important that's hidden behind here that you have to get here in the last second? Hopefully not something that requires you to do that again. Hi. Oh no, they're the flippy guys. Temple of the Soulless Stars. What? What? Yeah, God, you cannot imagine how much that pissed me off where whenever I talk a little bit loud, those new headsets would be like, ah, I can't handle it! Ah! And just go crazy. Okay, what's hidden behind here? I'm not getting anything. What the? Koopa the Quick? Koopa the Nesquik? What the heck are you doing here? Oh, look at that gate behind him. It's like moving. Uh-oh, I have lol number of stars. I better get another one before. Alright, well let's kind of look around here just so we can see kind of like where we're going to be racing to. Lots of tall grass here. I'm sure some of this place like hide something. This doesn't belong here. Like it's a nice area with like the blue striped trees and everything. I don't think there's anything up there. And also tall grass, it looks like it's that just hides like random enemies in it. I'm guessing this is just like a place. Oh, gee, thanks for that. Alright, so the flag is at the oh come on, at least we didn't get the one up. So the flag is at the very end, like behind the castle. Can I wall jump out of water? Is that something that's possible? No, Mars doesn't really do that. So I mean, it's nice out here. Really, it is. I'm serious. But there just doesn't seem to be a lot actually going on, if you know what I'm saying. I kind of hate how I got thrown in the water because I don't know what's going on up there, but I'd assume it's just the same thing, like it's just the same as the other side. It's a bunch of star enemies are just reskins of other enemies. And they're badly, they're just badly done. I hate to say it, but it's badly done, okay? I mean, we have a Chuckia that is a star, or it's not a Chuckia, it's a Flippy guy. The guys that are the bane of my existence. The guys that actually caused me to have to cheat in Mario's Nightmare. They were the reason for that. What, nothing else up here? It looks like it's just the same thing on this side too. Okay. So I'm guessing that it's just like the challenge of the race is going to be get to the flag of the other end by dodging all the enemies. Alright. I can see in there is a locked door and a sign. Huh. Alright. Let us race Koopa the slow. Oh, I'm sorry, I meant Brodute. Let's race the creator of this hack. Well, hello there, Mario. What brings you here? I'm trying to find a way to break the seal of this temple so that I can explore it. Well, the spirit of this place did away. The spirit of this place did away too good. Oh, okay, I can see. Okay, the spirit of the place did a way too good job on this. Alright, I understand that. That's, I don't know if that should be, if that two should have two O's or not. Okay, well, whatever. I'll give you that one. I'm not, because I'm not 100% sure either. Anyway, I guess you want one of my stars? Race me to the water, fall, and I give you one for winning. Ready? Go! Yeah, this is supersonic racing. Can't believe it. I kind of wanted to let the music play a little bit longer, but oh well. Oh well, I think I need a big idiot to break the seal. Hey, but something I noticed is that one of the trees here seems strange. But that's not my prob. One of the trees is strange. Oh, you... Bro, dude, you jerk. Why do you gotta put the star right up here? Here we go! A bonus star. So, going off that hint, hey, wait. Oh, gee, thanks for that, man. Oh, no. Stay away. That tree is a greenest blue or something, or would it be bluest green? Who cares? Yeah, and plus the trunk of that tree is red instead of brown, so... Okay, he won't grab onto that. So, what we will do instead, we will do something like this. I say. I'll walk along here. Now I can try to find out what's in the stupid tree. Whoa. Looks like a pedestal in there. Okay. Huh? Invisible cap! Oh! That's what was in there! Okay! Cool. I guess I just didn't see it from my angle. Alright. Warning, if you enter this temple without breaking the seal, you will end up in an broken world with all 7 stars. Just randomly sitting in places where they shouldn't be at. Well, I saved before, so... Oh, this is course 13! Broken. It's broken. It's distorted blue valley. You know what? We're just gonna forget that this place ever existed. Alright! I didn't think that would work, but it did. Well, that was a nice little diversion, wasn't it? I'm guessing that is where we go for course 13. It looked broken, but I mean, at the same time, it was called, like, blue area, so blue something or another. So I'm guessing it was supposed to be that way. Alright, well, that was pretty fun. That was a nice kind of open little area that didn't really have much in it. But it was nice. It was a nice aesthetic anyway. I guess in the end, I still didn't use any of the slippy guys to get me up there. So, yeah, screw them. Screw them. I forgot what place was next. We did course 8, obviously, so now we're looking for course 9. Hey, course 9, there we go. Oriental Volcanic Skies. Wow, that's racist, man. You can't say that. Over the Broken Bridge. Oh man, this song. Great. I don't know. I think Oriental is fine, but calling someone Oriental, that's racist. Alright. This is a good song, I like it. I remember where it's from? Not exactly. But I definitely heard it in another Mario hack before. Was it Mario and Luigi something? I don't know. But it is a good song, so we will accept it. We shall accept it! I don't think there's any, I'm just checking behind these stupid houses for any. Oh, hold on, what's that? Oh, hello, Lakitu, without his cloud spawned in. Just waiting for you. See, there is a giant hexagon over there with a star in the middle. That'll be fun to fly into eventually. Whether it be wing cap or... Oh, look, a cannon. That is, of course, locked. What is the star called? Over the Broken Bridge. Oh, oh my god, wait a second. Oh, that's not a star. That is... That's a secret that you have to collect. Alright. Hello, Lakitu friend. Oh wow, look at this broken bridge. I wonder if I should go over it. If only I had some sort of clue or some sort of hint that the game told me that I should get over it. So I'll just go up this volcano and we got a star. Here we go! That wasn't too hard.